favorite thing is to wait. When I go to the grocery store and I'm shopping, I look over the aisles, I see five there, three there, ten there, oh, ten it is. I'm going to get in the line with the ten people because there is nothing better than waiting. When I go to the amusement park, I look over the lines and how long it takes to get on the rock and roll roller coaster, hour and a half, the Harry Potter ride, 2 hours. Oh, wait. To tame Space Mountain 3 hours because there is nothing better than waiting in line for 3 hours. And my most favorite thing I do for waiting is when it's my birthday and people bring me presents, I say, that's all right, I'm going to wait till next year to open them. Has that ever happened to you? Do you say to them, I'll just save my present for next year because I love to wait? Who here loves to wait? Many people at my club meeting for those who love to wait. I don't think there's such a club. Well, that's kind of what happened in our scripture today. It's from the Old Testament, which is at the beginning of the Bible. And sometimes people say, how could something that happened so long ago in the Old Testament mean anything to me? Well, I'm going to show you what. So now we've been following these people who have been traveling with Moses leading them, and it's been kind of a hard journey. And we'll get back to that a little bit about what has happened to them as they've gone along. But today, now, Moses has gone up on the mountain to talk with God. And it says in the Bible he was there 40 days and 40 nights. But either way, it was a long time. And guess what? All those people were down there doing what? What were they doing, Natalia?
Waiting.
They were waiting. And they were waiting, and guess what? They didn't belong to the waiting club. They were not happy about waiting. So they decided Aaron, who Moses had left down there to be in charge, who was kind of not the best person to be in charge, kind of folded under pressure. And he said, all right, I'm going to do what you want. They wanted a God that they could see right now. They wanted to see what God was going to do for them. They wanted a God they could touch, a God they could hear right then. So they decided they would take all their gold and melt it down and make this calf or this cow, a big solid thing. Now, probably gold to you guys is not as important as it was to them. But I beg to say, what if I said to you, everyone should take out their cell phone, bring it up, and I would like to form something that we could worship with our cell phones. Or it might be your favorite video game that I ask you to put up. Or what's your favorite toy, Natalia?
What's your favorite one? What is it? Is it like a doll or a game or
well, you take your favorite thing and I ask you to bring it up here and we're gonna form something that we are gonna worship. We're gonna say this is more important than what Moses was doing up on the mountain. Well, now God finds out what they're doing up there. And he says, Moses, you need to get down. Because these commandments that I have made, these rules to follow, they have already broken the first two while you've been up here. So they're not doing very well. They are loving something ahead of me, and they have made something else to worship. So one and two are already gone. There's only eight more to go. Could be trouble before you get down the mountain. So he gets down there, and God is mad. Really, really mad. He's mad at the people because they weren't following the rules. That's why. He was mad. He wanted to grind up the calf, the gold, and mix it into the water and wanted them to drink it. Do you think that would taste very good? Oh, I don't think that sounds very delicious. Even if he added, like, you know, some chocolate syrup in there, I don't think it would be very good. I don't think it would be very good. So Moses says, hold on, hold on. And Moses is going to and I know you're really mad. It's like your best friend. Who's your best friend, Natalia? One of your best friends. Just give me a name.
Debbie.
It's like Debbie did the meanest thing ever to you, and your first reaction is maybe to do something mean back to Debbie. And that's how God felt. God felt like, I have done everything for you. When you needed something to eat, I gave you something to eat. When you needed something to drink, well, first of all, I broke you out of slavery, and you're on this walk, and then you were hungry, I gave you food. Then you needed something to drink. I gave you water. And now this is what you do. You choose this golden thing over me. So he's mad. And Moses says, wait, wait. I can do it. I can remind them all how you are the most important thing to worship. And Moses was able to do it. And it's a hard thing to wait. We're going to talk about it more in Connect today. It's a hard thing to wait when we don't think God hears us, and we don't think God's listening to us, and we can't really reach out and touch the love that God has for us. But we have to wait sometimes, because God will always come to us and always give us the right answer. Let us pray. Dear God, sometimes when we're waiting, we get scared. We're scared about what will happen. We're scared about what might happen to those we love. We're scared about what our reaction might be while we are waiting. And sometimes we make bad choices. Help us, God, to be able to wait in your love. Wait in knowing that you will always do what's best for us.